the viewers of Angel TV, and a special warm welcome to all of you, dear beloved children, who week after week have been watching Granny's Tele program. It is so nice again to get together, to worship God, to listen to what He has to say to us through some experiments. I'm so glad that we are together again. Now, make sure you got your pen and your paper to write down all the scriptures and the materials we're going to use for the experiment so you can do it at home with all your friends and with all your relatives. Now, are we happy? Are we happy?
Yes.
Okay, let's smile. Hallelujah. Because God is good and there is always something to be happy about. The moment that we wake up in the morning and we have breath, we should rejoice in the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So, what will be the name of this experiment? This is part two of Can It Be Done? So, Can It Be Done? We've done part one with the straw and the bottle. Remember, the straw was a little bit stubborn, didn't want to move much, just move very little. But I'm sure if you practice at home, it will move a lot. So this time, we are going to do Can It Be Done? Part two. Now, what's the aim of this experiment? The aim of this experiment is that we should be aware as believers not to reject the will of God and not to reject the Word of God and not to reject our Lord Jesus. So, God wants to work together with us, and heaven and earth working together with us. So let's welcome God. Let's welcome heaven in our hearts. Amen.
Amen.
We have to learn to let go at our ways of doing things, right?
Right.
So we can learn the ways of heaven. And heaven then and earth will be together through us. And this is what God wants to show us today. He wants to show us that when He gets near, some will reject because there is power in Him. And if in us there is something else, our flesh will reject the will of God. Our spirit might want to be close, but the flesh will reject. So guess who needs to be stronger, the flesh or the spirit?
Spirit.
You're right. Our spirit needs to be stronger because the flesh is an enemy to God. It will reject God's will. So we need to put the flesh down, resist it, just like we resist the devil. So our spirit man gets strong and we can work together with heaven. Amen.
Amen.
So, what do we need? Well, surely sometime at home, mommy or daddy might buy soft drink. It can be any soft drink. In this case, it's an empty Coca-Cola can. So, you need one. But because we are a few here, I just chose two of them. All right. So, you need that. And you need some balloons. Here you are. Yellow with yellow. And I'll have a red one. Okay, so you need the cans and the balloon. So now that we have all our material, it's time for
experiment!
Yes! first thing we are going to do is we are going to light down the can. Lie it down like that way. And the next thing we are going to do is we are going to rub the balloon on our hair. Rub, rub, rub. So at home, you get your hair and rub the balloon. Rub, 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 rub. Oh, it's very noisy. Just rub many places. Not just in one place, the balloon. Just turn the balloon around. Turn it around. Turn it around. And you, oh, it went away. Turn it around. Now, turn the balloon. Have a look. The balloon, I'm turning it around. So it's really well rubbed in. And once you rub it in, now my hair is going everywhere. So hopefully, what we need to do is bring the balloon close to the can, and you don't need to touch it. And here she comes. This is an exciting, this is what the straw should have done in the other one. But look at this, we are not touching it. Now, look at this. More charging, you need more charging? Come here, come here. Isn't that exciting? Let's see whether you can do this at home and with your friends. Can anyone make a can of Coke move without touching it? Well, can it? Yes! So first of all, you ask your friends, can you move this can without touching it? And you get them to try. You must not touch it. Can you move it? And they will try, won't they? And then you rub the balloon in your head and you say, I'm going to prove you that it can be touched. And after you rub the balloon in your head, then you bring close and you say, come here, come here, come here. See? Wasn't that exciting? That's very exciting, but what do can of Coca-Cola and balloons have to do with God? Well, let's put the balloons aside and let's look at the scriptures. At Matthew chapter 21, verse 42.
Jesus stood unto them that ye never read in the speech the strong with the builders other than the man is become the head of the country. This is the Lord doting and it is marvelous in the eyes.
Right. So we are saying that what the Lord is Jesus is saying unto the people, to the disciples, haven't you ever heard that the stone, the cornerstone that the builders rejected, was made the head cornerstone? So what is he talking about? Jesus was rejected. Who were the builders? The builders were supposed to be the Pharisees and the high priests, the Sadducees, all the high priests. But they rejected Jesus. They did not believe he was the Son of God. They were so full of themselves that they rejected him. But God the Father made him the head cornerstone. which is the most important stone in a building that will hold the building steady without falling. And this is what Jesus is for us, isn't it? He is the foundation of our faith. Without Him, our faith will crumble at the first difficulty we find. So, here He shows us that some will reject the Lord Jesus, and some will accept the Lord Jesus. Now let's look at Mark 8:31.
Then Jesus began to teach His disciples, the Son of Man must suffer much and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the teachers of the law. He will put to death, but 3 days later He will rise to life.
So what is the Lord saying?
The Son of Man.
Yes, who is the Son of Man? Do you know?
Jesus.
That's right. Jesus. So what is He saying?
Must suffer much by the elders.
That's right. Remember the previous scripture we said that the builders rejected the Lord Jesus. They rejected the stone that God made Him the cornerstone, the real foundation of the building, which is the foundation of the church, right?
Chief priest.
But the chief priest rejected Him.
And the teachers of the law.
And the teachers of the law, they rejected Him. They didn't want Him. So that word confirms. Now let's look at Luke 7:30.
But the hand had been baptized by John. By the Pharisees and the teachers of the law rejected God's purpose for themselves and refused to be baptized by John.
They refused to be baptized.
Baptized.
Okay. So what did the baptism mean?
That means
for all righteousness to be fulfilled. So for all things to become righteous, Jesus had to be baptized, even though He didn't have any sin, nothing to repent of. But John was baptizing for people to do what?
Pharisees and the teachers of the law.
Okay. What happened is, when we get baptized, we are cleansed from our sins. So He was baptizing for people to repent of their sins. And when they went into the waters, was a symbol, it was an act of faith saying, I agree to be washed by the word of God and be purified, repenting of all my sins. That's the baptism that John the Baptist brought. The baptism to repentance. But the Pharisees and the Sadducees, they did what? They did not get baptized. They rejected baptism. Mark 1:17.
Jesus said to them, come with me and I will teach you to catch men.
That's right. So what did He say?
Come with me, I will teach you to catch men.
Come unto me. That's right. Come with me. With this experiment, we're showing what Jesus really wants to do with all the people. Come to me, and I will show you how to be fisher of men. Amen. So, some will not come, will not want to come. Some will come. So, shall we pray that God will touch the hearts of all the little children of the world that don't know Jesus, that they will hear the voice of the Lord calling them to come? And shall we pray that we may be found worthy to be instruments of the Lord? Now, before that, let's look at the book of Luke 17:24.
As the lightning flashes across the sky and lights it up from one side to another, so will the Son of Man be in his day.
Verse 25.
But first he must suffer much and be rejected by the time of Noah.
Rejected?
People of today.
Okay, by the people of today. So, what is saying here? That the Lord Jesus is coming back.
Yes.
And just, have you been in the storms and seen the storm? The lightning goes, it starts from one end to the sky to the other end of the sky, shining like that.
No.
You never seen a storm? You never seen lightning? Have you? Yes. You have seen a lightning?
No.
No? Have you seen it in movies?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Have you seen it in real life?
No.
Okay. Some people see it in real life, some people see it in movies and real life. So just like the lightning goes from one end of the sky to the other end, in the last days, the Lord Jesus will come like a bright light upon the earth. And here in the scripture says that he will shine from one end to the other of the sky, of the heavens. But, he says, before he does that, he must suffer. And that's what he did. He suffered many things and he was rejected by that generation. So, even in this generation, many will reject him. And many of us will suffer because Jesus is inside and he suffers. And we suffer together with him. But then we are risen with him into glory. And as he shines in his return, so we will shine like stars. How wonderful! Can you imagine yourself shining like stars? Because the brightness of God is inside us. So shall we pray that the Lord will shine in us and that we will bring forth with his light many other children to know the Lord Jesus. Now, who's going to pray? Do you want to pray? Or do you want to pray? You want to pray? Okay. Close your eyes. Bow your head. And with all of your heart, ask the Lord. Okay? Father, in the name of Jesus, we ask you, dear Lord, that your heavenly hand be upon all the children of the world, especially in every one of those little ones that are watching Angel TV. Thank you for their lives. Thank you for loving each and every one of us. Thank you for your perfect plan of salvation you have. And thank you for teaching us today with this episode about real facts of the last days, that some will reject and some will accept. Lord, I pray that all the little children, they are watching Angel TV and Granny's Daily program, and even all those children that will hear your good news through them, Lord, they'll be all drawn unto you, and they will all be taken into the spirit run by your love. Lord, let this shine. Let them shine like lights, like stars. And when you return, Lord God, that all men may know that you love them and that they are one with you and you are one with them. Let the prophetic anointing of the last days rest upon them, even right now, Lord. That a zealous heart for you will be built within them. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
And we all say, Amen. Amen. Well, dear beloved, we have come to the end of this episode. So, if you have been blessed by the Lord through this program and through Angel TV, please write to us into the address that you see now in the screen and tell us about your testimony. We'll be so happy to hear from you. If you cannot write, get mommy and daddy or a sibling to write for us to know what the Lord has been doing for you. And until we meet again, God bless you.